Hello everyone, hope you're having the most wonderful day today. Welcome to Film Insight. For today's video, we're going to be discussing contestants that passed away on the Survivor show. So sit back and relax as we get right into the content. 1. Cliff Robinson, Cagayan. It's not every day we get to see athletes compete in game shows, but Cliff Robinson pushed the needle on the show's 28th season, Survivor Cagayan, Brains vs. Beauty vs. Brawn. Cliff spent almost 2 decades of his life as an NBA player. Per his Survivor bio, he played for the Portland Trail Blazers, Phoenix Suns, Detroit Pistons, Golden State Warriors, and New Jersey Nets, currently known as the Brooklyn Nets. Given his athletic abilities, the New York native was quickly seen as a threat to his competitors. As a result, he was eliminated on the 5th episode in a 4-3 blindside. Cliff had some pretty interesting experiences post-Survivor. After filming, Cliff traveled to North Korea with former NBA star Dennis Rodman as part of a game of basketball diplomacy for the 30th birthday of Supreme Leader Kim Jong-un. In 2016, Cliff opened up his own marijuana business called Uncle Spiffy. Cliff was hospitalized after suffering a brain hemorrhage in March 2017. The pro athlete died of lymphoma at the age of 53 on August 29, 2020. He is survived by his wife, Heather Lufkins, and son, Isaiah Robinson. 2. Rudy Bosch, Borneo. Rudy Bosch appeared on the iconic first season of Survivor. At the age of 72, Rudy joined a dominant alliance combined of Taggy tribe members Richard Hatch, Kelly Wigglesworth, and Susan Hawk. The group of four swiftly made it to the final, with Rudy placing third in the competition. 3 years later, Rudy returned to compete once more in All Stars at the age of 75. Unfortunately, he was the second person voted out. Rudy saw great success after appearing on Survivor. He appeared on shows such as Family Feud and JAG. Additionally, he attended Survivor's 10th anniversary party. In 2015, he was inducted into the Survivor Hall of Fame. Rudy died in a retirement community on November 1, 2018, from complications associated with dementia and Alzheimer's disease, per Entertainment Weekly. He was 91 at the time of his death. The Survivor Island of the Idols episode, I Was Born at Night But Not Last Night, was dedicated to the late star. 3. B.B. Anderson, Borneo. Real estate developer Bill Byron, B.B. Anderson, didn't vibe too well with his fellow Survivor Borneo contestants, and he was the second player eliminated from the season. One of the deciding factors in B.B.'s elimination was his comment that he wouldn't mind being voted out, a remark his team made good on. After appearing on Survivor, B.B. did commercials for Reebok and Home Depot. Additionally, he remained active in the construction industry in Kansas. He also remained engaged with fans, telling the Survivor Oz podcast, "People still would stop me and I would sign stuff. And then people would write me. I always answered everybody, and if anybody sent me a picture, I always sent it back to them. I would never be a jerk about it." B.B. died at age 77 from brain cancer, per Gold Derby. He is survived by his wife Jan and their daughter Alexandra, 4 sons Mark, John, Todd and Darren, and 8 grandchildren, according to his obituary. 4. Dan Kay, Gabon. One of the major reasons why folks enjoyed watching the Survivor reality TV series was learning how to cope with new people in new places. We loved it when 64-year-old B.B. Anderson kicked the younger contestants to the curb by telling them he didn't care if they voted him out or not. They were such characters who were always upfront and abrasive. Still, the show had the likes of Dan Kay, who played the people game to the maximum. Dan was some kind of a double agent, working for and with both the KGB and CIA. It takes a lot of charisma to convince one tribal party to take you in after working for its opposition and costing it dearly. What would happen to double agents if the KGB and the CIA were to ever merge? Dan never even made it to the jury, although he got pretty close. When the Survivor Gabon was at an advanced stage, the two opposing tribes were too small to compete. The show arranged a merger, and the elimination voting would be henceforth done by the merger tribe. Dan found himself outnumbered and outwitted. The tribe he had abandoned had more members in the merger than his newfound one. They voted him out, and we all learned an invaluable lesson. Sadly, the late Dan passed on back in 2016. His demise was unexpected and unforeseen at his 40-year age. 5. Jen Leon, Palau. Jennifer Jen Leon made her mark as the positive, optimistic contestant on Survivor Palau. What viewers also remember is her budding romance with fellow contestant Greg Carey. Jen ultimately finished the season in fourth place after being eliminated in the show's first fire-making tiebreaker against Ian Rosenberger. After Survivor, Jen appeared in the 2007 comedy Daddy Day Camp as Mrs. Simmons. Despite her deteriorating health, she also attended the 10th anniversary party for the show. Jen was diagnosed with stage 3 breast cancer in 2005, shortly after her season aired. She survived cancer and dedicated her time to spreading awareness about cancer research. Jen died on January 19, 2010, at the age of 37, after the returned cancer metastasized to the bone. Jen is the first Survivor star to die. 6. Caleb Bankston – Blood vs. Water. As the fiancé of One World contestant Colton Cumby, Caleb competed in the show's first Blood vs. Water season, featuring players with ties to one another. Caleb made it much further than Colton, who quit in the third episode, placing 8th. On the show, the couple were noteworthy for their polar opposite demeanors, with Caleb being the less dramatic of the two. Caleb and Colton stayed together as a couple after the show, and they were planning to get married in October of 2014. Sadly, Caleb died in a railway accident that June. He was working for the railway when the accident occurred during a derailment. He was 27 years old. 7. Sunday Berquist – Millennials vs. Gen X. Sunday was a Minnesota youth pastor who made it all the way to Day 35 in Fiji, which was when the alliance of Adam Klein, Hannah Shapiro, Ken McNichol, and David Wright voted her out. When she became a member of the jury, Sunday was one of the 10 people who voted unanimously to give Adam the $1 million check. She passed away of esophageal and ovarian cancer at the age of 50 after first being diagnosed with the disease in 2020. She previously survived breast cancer in 2012. Sunday joined the Survivor family in the 33rd season as the oldest woman on the hardworking Gen X tribe. 8. Angie Jacuz – Palau. New Orleans bartender Cassandra Ann Angie Jacuz stood out from her fellow contestants on Survivor Palau, with fans remembering the unconventional reality star for her colorful tattoos. On the show's first episode, Angie was almost voted out for being considered a weak link. Angie proved many of her peers wrong, becoming a fierce competitor and one of the strongest women of the Yulong tribe. Angie did not have her name written down until the 5th episode, where she was eliminated. Angie dealt with a lot of health issues after appearing on Survivor. In 2017, Angie was diagnosed with a rare form of squamous cell colorectal cancer. The following year, Angie's husband, Stephen Calandra, launched a GoFundMe to cover her medical costs. On January 8, 2021, Angie died from cancer complications at age 40. She is survived by her husband, parents, brother, niece, and nephew. 9. Ashley Massaro – China. Ashley Massaro was a woman of many talents. Aside from being a professional wrestler with the WWE, the New York native formerly competed as a gymnast in Miss Hawaiian Tropic pageants. Additionally, she's appeared in magazines such as Maxim, Playboy, and Candy. Massaro made her game show debut on season 15, Survivor China. Ashley was voted out unanimously on the second episode after her Zanhu tribe noticed how much she consistently clashed with tribe-age Dave Cruiser. Ashley returned to WWE in January 2008, but left soon after. Ashley died by suicide 11 years later on May 16, 2019, per the New York Post. She was 39. Before her tragic death, she agreed to star in a video for a song about suicide prevention written by one of her colleagues. Ashley was very enthusiastic about the song. Brian Orlando, the morning show host and assistant program director at 94.3 The Shark, told the publication. Massaro hosted a weekly show on the rock station. She heard it after it was recorded and loved it. She even agreed to be in the video. That would be all on today's video. I do hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, be sure to click on the like button below and comment your thoughts. Subscribe for more content like this and turn on post notification for instant access to our content. Have a good one, guys!